Aloha, I'm your Minna Van Dyken, MD from Out of the Doldrums. Today, we're gonna talk about a specific gut microbe called Akkermansia Mucinophila. We'll discuss why this particular bacteria is so important for your microbiome and overall health. And we'll go over six ways or strategies to increase Akkermansia in your microbiome. Throughout this video, I'm gonna refer to this bacteria as either Akkermansia Mucinophila, A. mucinophila, or Akkermansia. For the purposes of this video, all those terms refer to the same exact microbe. So first, what is Akkermansia? Akkermansia mucinophila has been nicknamed the gatekeeper of the gut. It is a mucus-degrading bacteria belonging to the phylum Verrucomicrobia. Akkermansia was first discovered in 2004 by a Dutch scientist named Muriel Derian, who was working in the lab of Willem de Vos at Wageningen University. It was named Akkermansia after Anton Akkermans, a Dutch microbiologist recognized for his contribution to microbial ecology. A. mucinophila is a gram-negative anaerobic bacteria, and it belongs to the phylum Verrucomicrobia. It's what we call a commensal bacteria, which means it's found naturally in our human gut. As a matter of fact, it represents 3 to 5% of the microbial community in humans. One interesting and unique thing about A. mucinophila is the fact that it likes to live in mucus. It likes to eat it. This bug has these long tentacle-like projections that produce enzymes that degrade mucus. Because of these enzymes, it does not need dietary substances to feed itself. It feeds off of the mucus. As a result, it has a very distinctive niche. It lives in that mucus layer that covers our intestinal epithelial cells. This is important because by living in this layer, Akkermansia is located very close to the cells of our body, and it's able to communicate with them and potentially regulate many important bodily and immune functions. Multiple studies suggest that Akkermansia mucinophila is associated with a healthier host organism. It's a highly promising probiotic too, because mainly it has a potential for prevention and treatment of insulin resistance, diabetes, obesity, and their associated metabolic disorders. Researchers have found that this bacterium is more abundant in the gut of individuals who are healthy, as opposed to individuals who have diabetes or obesity. Let's take a quick look at this landmark study done by Clara de Pommier et al. In 2020. They enrolled 32 overweight and obese insulin-resistant volunteers. They split these into three groups, a placebo group, a group supplementing with Akkermansia mucinophila, and a group supplementing with pasteurized Akkermansia mucinophila daily for 3 months. First, they found that supplementing with Akkermansia mucinophila was safe and it was well tolerated. There were no real side effects noted. More importantly, they found significantly reduced insulin resistance, significantly reduced total cholesterol levels, decreased body weight, decreased waist and hip circumference, reduced levels of inflammatory markers in the blood, and significantly decreased plasma LPS levels, which basically translates to improved gut barrier function. Lastly, they found that supplementing with pasteurized Akkermansia mucinophila appeared to have better results than the unpasteurized. That was a surprise, and it's very promising data. We don't know the exact mechanism by which Akkermansia exerts its beneficial effect on health. We do know that Akkermansia assures that the mucus thickness of the gut barrier is intact. Let's look at the big picture here. The lining of our gut is one cell thick. So there's one cell layer between the toxins in our poop and our bodies. That's nuts. Luckily, we have an overlying mucus layer that provides additional protection. This intestinal mucus has two layers, an inner layer that has no bacteria and a thicker outer layer that has commensal or friendly bacteria. This outer layer is a source of nutrients for A. mucinophila. It has just the right amount of protein, 20%, and carbohydrates, 80%, to flourish. You would think that this bacteria eating your mucus layer is a bad thing, but studies actually show that by consuming this outer layer of mucus, Akkermansia increases turnover of the mucus and stimulates the goblet cells of our intestine to create even more mucus. So more mucus means more of a protective barrier to prevent noxious agents, destructive hydrolases and microorganisms from directly contacting that one cell layer thick intestine wall. What's also interesting is that when Akkermansia mucinophila processes the mucin it is eating, it releases some very important components that are byproducts of this fermentation. It releases short-chain fatty acids like propionate and acetate, amino acids, and vitamins. All of these byproducts of fermentation instantly become available to the host, or us, and our other gut bacteria. Because Akkermansia supplies nutrients to other gut bacteria, it's considered a keystone species. So at the end of the day, what can Akkermansia mucinophila do, and why would we want to optimize levels of this in our microbiota? Well, first, it maintains normal permeability of the gut. Second, it prevents pro-inflammatory toxins from entering our bloodstream. Third, it prevents chronic tissue inflammation involved in metabolic disorders. It makes sense then that some scientists are calling it the gatekeeper bacteria. It seems to protect our gut from all sorts of badness. Fascinating. By the way, do you ever wonder how your gut microbiome is doing? How much Akkermansia do you have living inside of you? This can be easily tested with an at-home stool microbiome test kit. So, now we've established maybe we want more Akkermansia in our gut microbiome. How on earth can we do that? Well, here are 6 strategies to beef up your Akkermansia numbers. One caveat though, the science on all this is pretty new, with the majority of the studies done on animal models, not on humans. We definitely need more research on this topic, but for now, this is the best information we have. Number 1, supplement with Akkermansia mucinophila. This seems obvious, but it's important. In rats, supplementing with Akkermansia has resulted in a significant increase of Akkermansia in the feces. Interestingly, with the exception of the supplemented Akkermansia, these experiments did not show a change in the composition of the gut microbiome. This suggests that Akkermansia has minimum interaction with our other gut bacteria. Other experiments done on mice fed a Western high-fat diet saw a decrease in Akkermansia levels, and then they supplemented back the Akkermansia and they found that the abundance was then restored. This is a proof of concept demonstrating that it's possible to regain Akkermansia by supplementation. Even other studies demonstrate that supplementing with the bacterium can increase the thickness of the mucin layer and it can decrease intestinal permeability. Another study, this time done on humans, demonstrated that supplementing pasteurized Akkermansia in overweight individuals resulted in weight loss and improved insulin sensitivity. Number 2, supplement with other probiotics, not Akkermansia. There was an animal study that found that oral administration of a mixture of Lactobacillus rhamnosus and Bifidobacterium animalis for 14 days increased A. mucinophila abundance by about 100-fold. Number 3, work in some prebiotics and fructooligosaccharides. Administration of fructooligosaccharides, a common prebiotic, has been shown to promote the growth of Akkermansia. Other prebiotics such as inulin, psyllium husk or metamucil, oligochitosan, grapefruit pectin, all those have been shown to increase Akkermansia populations. Of all these prebiotics though, it does seem that the fructooligosaccharides are the most preferable nutrient for Akkermansia as it seemed to promote growth the most. Number 4, pack in the dietary polyphenols. Dietary polyphenols are natural antioxidants, and many of them, such as phenolic acids, flavones, and anthocyanins, possess strong antioxidant and antimicrobial activity. One study demonstrated that black tea or red wine grape extract, both containing complex dietary polyphenol mixtures, significantly promoted the growth of A. mucinophila. Another study had similar results with cranberry extract and Concord grape polyphenols. Other studies have demonstrated promising results with red pitaya, also known as dragon fruit, whole grain barley, and Ganoderma lucidum, also known as the reishi mushroom. Alternatively, you could find yourself some rhubarb extract. Supplementation of rhubarb extract drastically increased the abundance of A. mucinophila in mice fed a standard diet. The rhubarb increased the abundance from 9% to 38%. That's a pretty big increase. Researchers are attributing this finding to the anthraquinones that are found in rhubarb. Alternatively, add some tempeh to your diet. This study, done in 14 human participants, demonstrated that eating 100 grams of steamed tempeh daily increased your Akkermansia mucinophila in the GI tract. Number six, avoid a high-fat diet and avoid alcohol. Many studies have consistently shown that high-fat diets significantly reduces A. mucinophila abundance. Alcohol intake also negatively affects Akkermansia populations, and this is accompanied by increased inflammation and oxidative stress. Okay, it's a wrap. At the end of the day, we definitely need more research on this topic, but we've got some pretty strong data to start with. I'm definitely awaiting more human studies so we have stronger data on this. We want to hear from you. What strategies are you using to increase Akkermansia in your gut microbiome? Are you measuring it? If so, how? If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. Until next time, everyone, stay safe, stay healthy, and aloha.
Go for a swim.
Whew. Maybe one day, not today. It's a little cold.